Hello everybody, Venomous Hail back here for the first time in quite a while. Today I want to show you a video about crafting nodes or harvest nodes in ESO. Since they started making the furrier traps and clother surveys, there hasn't been a whole lot of cloth available for light armor at a reasonable price. So I'll show you an example of this. This is PS4 North America. If you're in Mournhold, that's fuck. All right, let's go to the crafting and just look at the price of some of these materials. All right, we'll sort it by the most expensive, which is probably going to be Ancestor Silk. Look at that. All right, that's Ebon Thread. Of course, nobody's bought that because it's got 8 days left, and nobody's gonna buy that because that's fucking retarded. It's 25k for 200, and hide is 20,000 for 200. Ancestor silk is, you know, anywhere from 15 to 20k for 200. That's ridiculous. That's just silly. All right, so this video, I'm gonna show you a really good route to run if you want to get some good amounts of materials. And this isn't just the, you know, the clothing stuff. This is also going to be the metal and wood. Alright, so what I'm going to do real quick is I'm going to refine what's in my inventory. That way I don't have hardly anything left. And that way we'll get a good measure of how many we get. Alright, so I have zero in my inventory as far as Ancestor Silk goes. It's okay, game. I don't want any tempering alloys anyway. All right. Go refine the wood and we'll be good to go. You're going to start this. You're going to be in Deshaun when you're doing this. And you're going to start in Mournhold. Now you're going to go right out the gate by the Undaunted Enclave. And that's where the route is going to start. So let's go down here and get into our starting position. And I'll kind of go over it on the map with you of where we're going. And the general route that we're going to take. Alright, so here we are. Front gate, Mournhold. Now, we're going to head down this road. We're going to stop up here and swing back around down here, and then we're gonna hit the Ghost Snake Veil. Alright, and then we're gonna go around these rivers down through here. We're gonna hit both of these, and this is the way shrine that we will fast travel from when we're done. So we're gonna walk from Mournhold to this way shrine. Alright, and this really helps if you, shit, in your champion skills, if you have more than 75 in the lover, that really helps. Because one, you get plentiful harvest at 10. So at least put 10 in there, because that's going to get you a little extra. And then at 75, you get to harvest the nodes twice as fast, so it doesn't take as long to do this. Alright, so we're going to run down the wall here. Here. Oh, look, Thieves Guild Trove. All Now this is going to be the same on all three platforms. All of the nodes are the same. Every server, it doesn't change. Okay. Sometimes the ones that I have on my screen won't be there because somebody's already went through and got them. And you'll see some of them that I don't see because somebody's got them on my game already and they haven't respawned yet. So I haven't played on Xbox. That is the only platform that I haven't played the game on, is Xbox. I have it on PC. You know, I've obviously tested this on PC. All of the nodes are in the exact same spot. It shouldn't be any different from Xbox. This is going to save you a lot of money, and it may even help you make some money. If enough people see the video, it may drive down the price of the materials. And that would be nice, because nobody wants to pay 20,000 gold a stack for some fucking cloth to do through the Ritz. Some down here that I've missed. Oh, okay. Carry on. Go over here. Jumpy little bastard today. I usually stop up here and hit all these Dwemer pots, backpacks. I don't really need any of that stuff, but sometimes I find motives, patterns, stuff like that. See, I'm stopping, you know, every few seconds to grab something that's loaded with stuff. There's not a whole lot of enemies to kill. So you can just kind of run right through and grab your stuff and be on your way. Sometimes right here on this little island there's a chest. I've ran this route quite a bit. Well, not a whole lot, I guess 5 or 6 times maybe. But it's effective every time. I have a lot of supplies built up. I've even sold quite a bit, made some money. Sometimes there's a chest right there. That's what I thought, bitch. That guy's farming too, I think. What the hell? There's usually like three or four right there. In that little route that I just ran. These chests, open all of those. They have a chance to drop the Mother Sorrow set. As you just seen, I got a belt out of it, which really isn't worth anything. But if you get this the sharpened one-hand sword, that's at least 300k that you can sell that for. So that would totally be worth your little trip around this area. get too close to that guy because he'll whip your ass. No, he's, I mean, he's pretty tough. He's a ward boss, but you can, I mean, you can solo him if you have the right stuff and the right setup. Actually looked up here. What the fuck? Sometimes there's a chest right here in the water. There's our way shrine, but we're gonna keep getting this area right here because there's a big portion of it that I haven't covered yet. Just be careful over here by this boss. C2 will whip your ass. I've not been able to solo this one. I think that'll about do it. So let's check out our results. Smithing. So we got 151 ore. Well, I guess 146 because we started with five. So pretty good run for that. Clothing. Yeah, see, I have almost 1,000 ancestor silk. That's not from this run. That's already refined. But I got 119 from that run. So, what, that took 20 minutes maybe. And then wood, got 84. So, that's a pretty good run. And I think that anybody that does it would save themselves a lot of money. It might take about 20 minutes to do it, and do it a few times, but it's totally worth it in the long run, in my opinion. So, well, that's it for this video. Any other videos that you all want to see like this, just leave a comment, hit that like button, and I'll see you next time.